Hello everyone, I welcome you all to my channel Green Knowledge. This is Cnc Programming Series Part 1. In this series, we are going to talk about Cnc Programming and learn them from basic to advanced level. In this video, we are going to cover Gcodes and cover every Gcode one by one. So let's start. Talking about Cnc, Cnc is a blind machine, but very accurate and fast because Cnc is a good listener. It will follow whatever the human operator is going to command, and these instructions and commands to the Cnc is given by Cnc program. Cnc programming consists of various codes like G code, M code and other alphanumeric values. In this part of the video, we will focus on G code. G code full form is geometric code, and it tells the machine where to move, how fast to move and what path to follow. Like if my tool is at point O, x0, z0 and I want to move to point P, so I will write x50, z60. It also tells how fast to move, like what should be the tool speed while moving from point O to P. And what path to follow, I meant that in a straight line or in a curved path, like this. Talking about G-code types, there are two types of G-codes, modal G-codes and non-modal G-codes. Modal codes are divided into groups and these are named as group 1, group 2, group 3 and so on. Modal codes are those codes which will remain active throughout the program until and unless another code is written from the same group and replace the other. Example, if we have written our program like this, like Z0, X40, Z60 in next block, X20, Z90, next X10, Z10, then G0 code is active in all of these three blocks. But in fourth block, we have written G01, which will cancel and replace G0 because it is from the same group. It is an important point to note that if two or more modal codes are written in same block from different group, then they will still remain active. And if two or more modal codes are written in same block from same group, then G code at the last one will replace all and stays active. On the other hand, if we talk about non-modal codes, these are called one-shot codes. That is, they are active in a single block only. And when the next block comes, they deactivate themselves. Example, G04, which is basically used for a dwell period. Now, you can see the list of G codes, whether they are modal or non-modal, and which group they belong, and what are their basic functions. G00 for rapid travel, G01 for linear interpolation, G02 and G03 for clockwise and counterclockwise circular interpolation, and there are other codes like G20 and G21 for selecting inch or metric system. G41 and G42 are used for tool nose radius compensation left or right. G90 and G91 are used for absolute or incremental programming. G17, G18 and G19 are used for selecting planes whether we want XY, ZX or YZ. There are also other G codes, which are known as canned cycles. Canned cycles are used to perform drilling, turning, grooving, threading, finish turning and boring etc. operations in a very convenient way. You can use these codes like G71 for rough turning cycle, G72 for facing cycle, G75 for grooving cycle and G76 for threading cycle. First we have G00, which is used for rapid travel. This code is used when tool don't have to do cutting, but we want to change its position from point A to point B at maximum speed. It is normally used when going home for a tool change and returning back with a new tool. Remember, it is in this mode you can cause most damage to the CNC if you didn't programmed correctly. Example of G00 like G00 X100 Z20. This block will move my tool from current position A to B coordinate X100 Z20 at maximum speed. Next code G01, which is used for linear interpolation. This code is used when you want to do cutting in a straight line. For cut, you don't want your tool to move at maximum speed, so we have to provide feed rate either with G01 or before G01. Basically, we want our feed rate to be active. In turning operation, feed rate provided is in millimeter per revolution, that is how much millimeter we want to cut in one revolution. You can see the example of G01 code. In this, we provide XY as a final coordinate where we want to go and F for the feed rate. Next come G02 and G03. These are used for circular interpolation. G02 for clockwise circular interpolation, as you can see, and G03 for counterclockwise circular cutting. We know that whenever we want to draw an arc, we need a starting point, an end point, and a radius. Our current position is our starting point, and the XZ coordinate which we provide with G02 or G03 is our end point, and for radius, we give it with R value. Example, if we are at X20, Z minus 10, and we have written G02, X40, Z minus 20, F0.15, and R5, then we will do cutting like this. But if we used G03, X40, Z minus 20, R5, F0.15, then cutting will occur like this, that is in counterclockwise direction. Note, if we use negative sign before R value, example minus R5, then similar radius circle with a longer arc will be cut, as you can see in the screen. Both of these circles are equal in radius, but the arc length different. Next come G20 and G21, which are used for selecting inch system and metric system. G20 is used if you want to program in inch unit, and G21 for metric unit, millimeter. In country like America, they use inch system mostly, and in India, we use metric system. G20 and G21 are written usually in the starting of the program to let Cnc know that we have written our program in which unit. Next come G28. It is used for automatic return through reference point. This code will perform two functions. First, it will bring tool to a reference point which we have to give with U value and W value. This U and W value are the incremental access position which we can use even in absolute programming. Second, then it will bring tool to the home position, that is into the machine origin. First, G28 U0 W0. As U and W values are 0, so our incremental access position will be 0 and our current position will become the reference position. And after that, our tool will return to the home position. Next, G28 U10 W10. As U is 10, then X will increase by 10 and tool will move up by 10 by 2 is equal to 5 mm, which is our reference point. And then it will return to the home position. This code is basically used to safely move our tool back to the home position without striking to any kind of machine elements like clamp, etc. Next, we have G04 for dwell period. It is a non-modal code used to stop your tool at some position for some second. For that, we use P code with G. In P, we define number of seconds we want to hold the tool. Example, G04 P06 will stop the tool at current position for 6 seconds and then move on to the next block. With G04, only the tool will stop, but spindle and coolant will remain in on position. We use this code while drilling, grooving, or parting off. It helps to break the chips. Next we have G41 and G42. G41 for tool nose radius compensation left and G42 for right. When we have to perform step turning, then we don't need this compensation and we usually don't use G41 and G42. But for taper turning, to get exact profile which we want, we need to give G41 and G42 values for compensation. We know that tip or nose of the tool have some radius, and when we have to perform taper turning, the contact between tool and workpiece changes when we go upward and downward. Due to this, exact profile is not obtained. When tool is moving upward, it leaves some material, and when coming downward, it cuts extra material. Also, in Cnc turning, we use different orientation of tool to perform the turning operation. Example, in screen you can see different tool orientations like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. The number given to these orientation are standard. For example, if we are going to use first orientation, then our tool will be like this. G41 and G42 are used to call this tool nose radius, example 0.4 mm, 0.8 mm, and tool orientation, as we have seen 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 9, which is stored in geometric offset. When viewing from the direction when the tool is moving away from us, for the left side we use G41 code and for the right side we use G42. That is, when we are going from this path we use G41 and for that G42. And for the boring operation, the things become opposite. And on the other hand, G40 used to cancel this compensation. Next we have G17, G18 and G19. All of these are modal codes and are used for selection of planes. The selection of planes should be such that in which face we are going to do the machining. As we know that plane consists of two axes. For example, for turning we use Z and X axis plane. And G17 is used for XY plane selection, G18 for ZX plane selection, G19 for YZ plane selection. So we use G18 for turning operation. And for milling, top face of our working, we use G17, that is XY plane. Next we have G90 and G91. G90 for absolute programming and G91 for incremental programming. In absolute programming system, all X and Z dimensions are given with respect to work piece 0. And incremental programming system, all X and Z dimensions are given with respect to tool current position, as you can see in the screen. We have to mention this code at the starting or whenever required, about which positioning system we are using. Next, we have G96 and G97. G96 is used to give constant surface speed and G97 to cancel this constant surface speed command. We know that surface speed formula is V is equal to pi dn upon 1000, where d is the diameter of the workpiece and n is the revolution per minute, that is RPM of the workpiece. If workpiece RPM is 1000 and we are increasing diameter, then surface speed will keep on increasing, which is bad. So we use G96 to provide constant surface speed. And to cancel this constant surface speed command, we use G97. On the other hand, similarly, if we talk about chuck spindle speed, that is RPM of workpiece, it is equal to V into 1000 upon pi into diameter. If V is 50 meter per minute and we are decreasing diameter, then chuck spindle speed will keep on increasing, which is also bad. So for that, we use G92 to provide maximum spindle speed. Next, we have G98 and G99. In CNC turning, feed rate can be provided in two types of units, millimeter per minute with G98 and millimeter per revolution with G99. Millimeter per revolution with G99 is mostly used in CNC turning because it provides better understanding about cutting rate of our tool. Now let us understand what are canned cycles. If you want to perform drilling, turning, grooving, threading, finish turning or even boring, again and again you have to write a long sequence of program. But with canned cycles we can write this conveniently and briefly. It simplifies the program by using one or two block Gcode with subroutine program. Let us discuss some of them. G71, which is used for rough turning cycle. This operation is performed usually in two blocks. The syntax of this canned cycle is as you can see in the screen. Similar to G71, we have G70. It is used for finish turning cycle. The syntax of that as you can see. Next we have G72 for facing cycle, G75 for grooving cycle and G76 for threading cycle. And all of the syntax you can see in the screen. Every alphabet in this syntax has a certain meaning and a function to perform. To understand them well, we need time. But for now, I wanted you to go through all of these G codes and understand them well. I will make videos on every canned cycle like G71, G72, G76 in upcoming videos. This video was just an overview of G code, which are usually used in CNC turning. If you want to study them more deeply, I will make videos one by one on every G code in order to make you understand. and we can complete our goal to become a CNC programmer. So thank you everyone. I hope you liked the video. If you did, then please hit the like button and subscribe the channel. Till then, have a nice day.